Hi, it's Corey, and today you're going to learn how to play Into the Unknown from Frozen 2. So before we get started, the lead sheets for this song can be found on my Patreon, so if you're not already a member of that community, you can find the link in the description and you can check it out for yourself and see if it's a good fit. I have a ton of other resources on my Patreon as well that are really useful for both beginner and advanced ukulele players, so if you are interested and you want another way to support the channel outside of just viewing, which I super appreciate, and subscribing, and I appreciate that as well, all the information is in the description box. So for this song, which is awesome, I mean, I personally like it a lot more than Let It Go. Also, it didn't hurt that like Brendon Urie covered it for the like artist version of the song. Just as a warning, some of the chords are chords that you may have never heard of before. So just prepare yourself and be ready to maybe take a little bit of time to learn this song. You're also going to be using three different strumming patterns for this, but they are very, very beginner friendly strumming patterns. So in all, it's just basically about putting all those different pieces together and making it work for you. And as always with any of my tutorials, take what works for you. And if you want to change something, do whatever you want to make this song your own. I did make this as like a simplified version of the song as possible, but what is great is at least it's in the original key still, so if you wanted to play along with the recording, you can still do that. So let's just jump in, but first things first, let's make sure your ukulele's in tune. I'm using a soprano ukulele today. This particular one I actually have a review of on my channel, so if you want to check it out and see if you like it for yourself, it's a really nice soprano ukulele from Donner. I will have that video up in the cards. For your ukulele be in tune, that's going to be a G on the fourth string, a C on the third string, an E on the second string, and an A on the first string. So to start, you're going to need to know an A7 major, and this is a really easy chord. You just take your first finger and place it on the third string of the first fret. And then you also have just a regular A major, which is similar to the F major, if you know what that chord is, but you're taking your first finger, placing it on the first fret, third string, and then taking your second finger and placing it on the second fret, fourth string. Next, you're going to need to know a B major chord. If you're familiar with the B flat, which is a little bit more commonly used, all you have to do for a B major chord is move down a fret, but it's that same position. So that turns into your first finger barring on strings 1 and 2 of fret 2, your third finger on fret 3 of string 3, and then your third finger on fret 4 of string 4. And there's your B major. You're also going to need a B minor chord. And for B minor, this is also another barred chord. You're taking your first finger and you're going to bar across the second fret. And then you're going to use your second finger to press down on that as well to support your playing. And then you're going to take your third finger and place it on the fourth string, fourth fret. And there's your B minor chord. You're going to really want to put that thumb right behind the second fret to support it as you're playing. If you need any extra help with any of the barred chords in this song, I'll make sure to link my tips and tricks for barred chords video, and you can check that out and get a lot better at playing barred chords. You're also going to need a C major, and you probably are familiar with this. If you're not, it is a third finger on the first string, third fret. You're also going to need a C minor, and that's going to be your first finger on the third fret, but you're barring on strings 1, 2, and 3. And what you're going to do with your thumb is you're going to put it right behind that finger on the third fret, but behind on the neck. And there's the C minor. You're also going to need to know a C sharp minor, which is similar to the C minor chord, but what you're doing is starting on the fourth fret. You're taking your first finger and you're going to bar across, similar to what you're doing with C minor. So essentially it's down a fret, and you're taking your third finger and then placing it on the sixth fret. So if you need to, you can count down on your ukulele fretboard and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or if your particular ukulele happens to have fret markers on the side, almost all ukuleles have the first fret marker on the fifth fret. So it's going to be the one right between the fifth and the seventh, which they're commonly there. And then that's going to be your C sharp minor. You can also take that second finger like I'm doing here and support it on the first finger to just help get that bar an extra squeeze and to make sure all of the strings are going to sound correctly. So that's that C sharp minor. We only play that once in the entire song, so it is kind of an important one because it's at that outro, so you can have that really epic moment. But just know, another thing you could do is you could just bar across the entire fourth fret, and that's okay too. Next, you're gonna need to know the F major chord, and that's gonna be your first finger played on the first fret, second string, and then your second finger on the second fret, fourth string. You're also gonna need the D minor chord, which is kind of an extension of the F major. So if you go into that position of the F major, all you're doing is adding that third finger on the third string, second fret. But if you need to build that up, it's your first finger on the second string, first fret, your second finger on the second fret, fourth string, and then, like I said, placing that third finger on the third string, second fret. And we also have a D major chord, which is going to be your first finger on the second fret, fourth string, your second finger on the second fret, third string, and then your third finger on the second fret, second string. And then we also have a G major chord. That's going to be your first finger on the second fret, third string, your second finger on the first string, second fret, and then your third finger on the third fret, second string. And then finally, we have finally gotten to the last chord in this song. It's going to be an E major. Now, E major is one of my least favorite chords, and there are a number of ways how to play it, and this is what I personally find to be the easiest way. So what you're going to do to play this E major is you're going to bar across the fourth fret with your first finger, and then you're taking your fourth finger or your pinky and you are going down to the seventh fret. Now, like with all the other bar chords, you can take that second finger and help get extra support by laying it on top of the first. Now you can tell that this is going to be a much higher because of this extra right there, but I find it to be the easiest way how to make like an actual E major chord. A lot of times in my tutorials, I will exchange an E7 for an E major because it's easier to play, but I think it's a good challenge and the E7 doesn't really work in this particular song. So, like I said, you have that E major chord. So in total, that is 12 chords all together playing this one song. And it's something I've noticed a lot about Disney songs in general is a lot of times people think, oh, kiddos are supposed to be singing these, but they're not easy songs. So don't get frustrated if it's going to take you a few run-throughs of the tutorial or the video to be able to get everything in order. Let's talk strumming patterns. So for the strum patterns for this song, we're going to be using a combination of just a down, 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 down strum, which I call on the beat. And that's going to be played throughout the entire intro and the first verse. And then you'll go back to it for verse 3 really briefly before going into the main strumming pattern. And the main strumming pattern is a combination of a down, down, up, up, down, and a down, chuck, up, up, chuck. So your option here is if you don't know how to chuck, you could A, watch my how to chuck video and then do the chucking. The only difference between the main strumming pattern, which we use on the chorus and then everything throughout the bridge as well to the end of the song, is going to be the chuck. So it's just the difference between a down, down, up, up, down, or a down, chuck, up, up, chuck. That sounds like this. So I'm just gonna play it on a C major here. We have a down, down, up, up, down. That is what the strumming pattern is, and then with the chuck, it's down, chuck, up, up, chuck. Slow down, that's down, down, up, up, down. With the chuck slowed down, it's down, chuck, up, up, chuck. And the only difference here is that with the chucks, you're strumming down on the first down, and then every other down in the pattern gets changed to a chuck. What you're going to have is starting out at the very beginning, you'll have down, 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 down. When you get to the second verse, you'll have down, down, up, up, down. When you get to the pre-chorus, you start with the down, chuck, up, up, chuck, all the way through the chorus. then you go back to the down, 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 down. Then you go back to the down, check, up, up, check, main strumming pattern that you're gonna use throughout the rest of the song. If that seems a little bit overwhelming with all the different chords and the three different strumming patterns, watch the playthrough first, get familiar with it, and then come back to these different parts and then practice them individually. It's totally normal and fine to watch the finished product and then start working on the pieces yourself. But number one thing is, don't get frustrated if you can't play it the very first time. You don't see the behind the scenes where I'm kind of working through things and practicing it myself. So I don't just like look at these songs and play them perfectly the first time either. So I don't expect for you to be able to either. But if you're able to, that's cool too. Also, as always, you're always more than welcome just to keep playing on the steady beat or on the chord changes if that's what you're comfortable with. You don't have to play it the exact same way as I do. That's what I meant when I said before of like, take the pieces that work for you and then make it your own. But with that, let's give it a playthrough. One, two, here we go. I can hear you, but I won't. Some look for trouble while others don't. There's a thousand reasons I should go about my day and ignore your whispers, which I wish would go away. Oh. Parts in the playthrough where I just added a little bit of extra pause. And I think this is just for like stylistic purposes. So one example is like at the very, very end where I have the "How do I follow you?" pause into the unknown, and then I finish it with the B there. So that is totally something that you can have as an option. I hope you found this helpful. Like I said, if you haven't already, make sure to hit the subscribe button, give this song a like. If there are other songs from Frozen 2 that you like, make sure to comment down below. There are a few that I really liked from it, so maybe they're the same and I'll make a tutorial for it. But I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.